Welcome back to Police Quest 1. I'm your host, Lostwolfe, and last week we had a look at an accident that occurred. So now what we have to do is we have to drive around for a little bit more. A lot of this game is a bit like this. You spend a lot of time kind of driving around and waiting for things to happen, which is what I'm going to do now. That was silly. The light was green there. I'll just drive against the traffic. That sounds good. Because I can break the rules. I'm a police person. Anyhow, one of the things that I wanted to mention last week that I didn't mention, by the by, is if those of you who played Grand Theft Auto have been watching this and looking at it and going, wait, I recognize this style of thing. That's probably because Grand Theft Auto was sort of inspired by this, maybe, in a small sort of way. So we're going to go and just kind of casually drive around and see what there is to see. Whoops. I see nothing special. This is a bit scary. There are too many cars. I'm so freaked out. Look. You're at the streets near Carol's Caffeine Castle and the famous Wino Wileys. Really? Willies? Beardrake. That's awkward. Well, okay. So, yeah. Hopefully there isn't quite as much fail as there was last week, and I'm sorry about that. It just all sort of went wrong where I crashed a car, and it took too long to get anything done, and all that kind of thing. So hopefully we won't have a lot of that this episode. Our plan is just, we're going to see a couple of more incidents that you can have in the game. And that is basically how almost the first half of the game plays out. You get a bunch of incidents and you deal with them. So we're kind of casually just going to drive around and wait until our radio squawks at us and says things. Tells us where to go and what to do. Good lord, that was close. All these scary cars doing scary driving. I hope everyone's doing okay and having a good Easter. Mine is pretty laid back. Went and had a barbecue with some friends and ate a bunch of chocolate, and that was about it. Other than that, there we go. Steve Radio is 8332. This is 8331. Time for 1198 at Caffeine Castle. Right, so we're gonna go the other way. Sorry. This LP is going to be littered with that. I am so sorry. Okay, I'm going to drive around for a bit again. I'm going to wait for the call to come in so that we can go and meet Steve at Carol's. Right, I shall see you folks again very shortly. Sorry about that. Right, and so we've been called to Carol's Caffeine Castle. We're going to have a break. As you can see there already, Steve has parked his car, and we just need to park our car. Park. Okay, now find a good place to stop. Oh dear. Park. There we go. Okay. Get out of car. No, really, park. Prack? Park. Okay, open door. Get out of car. Close door. Let us go and hear what Steve has to say for himself. In we go. And there's our buddy Steve. We're gonna grab a seat. Sit. Okay. Right. We're going to talk to Steve. Hey, Sonny, it's good to see you. Yeah, it is good to see you. Okay. Right, so we're just gonna evidently hang out here for a little while and see what happens. Cowell sets your coffee down and says, "Here you go, big boy, one caffeine IV." Right, we're gonna drink our coffee. You slam back the entire mug of Jamaican Java. Your eyeballs roll back in your head. Let's have a look around. Steve looks like he's on a caffeine high. Talk to Steve. Boy, this weather's been great. Yeah. Yeah, there's two lines. There's the phone. It goes. Okay, so Cal goes over and she's going to answer it. Cal yells at you from across the room. "Officer Bonds, there's Detective Hamilton on the phone for you." Right, get up. Let's talk to the man. How does he know I'm here, by the by? That's a bit scary. Right, use phone. You take the phone here. "Bonds, this is Detective Hamilton. We identified the 187 victim in the car as Lonnie West, a local small-time drug dealer. Believe it or not, he's the second small-time to get his ticket punched in the last 2 weeks. Right, I just wanted you to know about West since you worked the scene. Gotta run, got another call waiting. Don't spend the whole day drinking coffee. So, we're gonna just make a note of Lonnie West. By click. Right, and we're gonna go, and we're gonna finish off a little break with Steve. Okay, right, we're gonna sit. Again, and we're gonna talk to Steve. Boy, this weather's been great. Okay, so we're gonna leave, and we're gonna drive around again. So we're going to just take a nice stroll outside, and we're gonna walk around for a bit. Well, by walking around, I mean we're gonna get into our car. Do you plan to call through the window? Yes, I do. Open door. Get into car. Fasten belt. Close door. Seat belt. Drive. Now, I've learned my lesson, so we're gonna save a lot. Okay, so we're gonna drive around for a little while more, and the plan is that I'm going to try and do sort of 2 incidents per episode, and you may only ignore intersection controls when operating a control bar, a patrol car in code 3 status, and even then only using due caution. And it's going to kill me, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Fantastic. And that's why we saved, because I'm going to have a lot of that. So, I'm gonna try and sort of keep this to 2 incidents per episode so that it's not quite so overwhelming to watch. And I mean, all of the incidents are kind of like a couple of minutes apart, so that should be good for us. Wow. I nearly got myself killed there. I'm just gonna stick to the middle of the road. The middle of the road seems good to me, because that way I won't die quite so much, like I nearly did there. Yeah, this is going to be a lot of saving. I can just see it now. Part of the problem with this game is that I'm not very good at dexterity. I'm also not good at English, evidently. I'm not good at dexterity puzzles or dexterity things, so I don't play that sort of game very much. And this whole driving section, to me, is just, it's, you know, it's one great big dexterity challenge. If I could have gotten away from doing this, I would have. But alas, you can't. So I'm also on the wrong side of the road. Yeah, there we go. You're gonna keep on just driving around, and you cruise your beat just aching to write a ticket. Okay. Oh, no. Bad car. Don't come near me, thank you. Yeah. This is tricky enough as it is. Did you see that red sports car run that red light? No, I didn't, but I think I know where it is. There it is. Oh, good lord. Really? I'm going to have to speed this up a fraction, which is going to be a bit scary. There she goes. Okay. This is the red sports car. Let's not get ourselves killed. There we go. You activate your red emergency lights and observe the sports car pull to the curb and stop. Right, that was what I wanted to do, so we're gonna park and we're gonna save. Red sports car. Right, okay, so we're gonna open the door. We're gonna get out. Close the door. We're gonna just walk over and say hello to the lady and see what's up. Okay. Look, lady. As you look into the car, you wonder, can this be happening? The young lady has a smile that could melt the polar ice caps, beautiful flashing eyes, gorgeous hair, and her unbuttoned blouse makes it obvious she has nothing to hide. Talk to lady. My name is Helen. Helen Hotz, she says, as heat detectors go off for miles around. What's yours, handsome? Sonny Bonds. Good day, ma'am, you say, trying to keep your glance high. I'm Officer Sonny Bonds. Right, so I'm truly sorry, sir. I honestly didn't see that red light. Is there anything I can do to convince you to let me off? And I do mean anything. No. Okay, that's her rap sheet. Being the veteran that you are, you overcome temptation and stare the young lady straight in the eyes. May I please see your driver's license, ma'am? So she gives it to you. She's Helen Hotz, female, 5'2", 105 pounds, hair black, eyes blue, date of birth, 2/14/66/202, gyrate court, possibly, Lytton, California, restrictions none. Okay, so you ran a red light. Politely tell her, you ran a red light back there, miss. She's not very happy. I'm truly sorry. No. Okay, so we're gonna write her a ticket. Right, ticket. And you carefully fill in all the necessary information on the citation. She's hopping mad as she yells, oh, you cops are all alike. All you care about is making your quotas. Well, come on, snap it up. I'm in a hurry, Mr. Big Shot Traffic Cop. Guys like you make me want a big dip of snuff. You never give a decent girl a break. You just hassle people. Okay, she's not totally happy about this. Right, so we're going to give the license back to Lady. And then we're going to give her the ticket. Signed ticket. You handed the ticket book in your pen. Please sign it to X-Spam, you politely instruct her. She hands your ticket book back and suggests, with a sarcastic smile, "Why don't you shove that pen where the sun don't shine, officer? Mommy and Daddy." Really? Okay, that doesn't make much sense. Right, okay, so we're gonna give her the ticket. She verbally pounds you again. "Officer, did your mother have any children that lived?" She's not very happy at all. Okay, and off we go. She replies in a heated voice, "Just remember, fish breath, I'm gonna file a complaint on you. I'll cheat, lie, and do anything possible to get you, your little fuzz butt, in trouble. You hear me?" We need to radio on home. "Dispatch, this is 8332. Run once on Ocean, Henry, Mary, Yellow, Mary, George." Dispatch returns with information on your requested OHMYMG is currently registered to Helen Hotz. No wants. Right, that's good. So we're gonna get into a car. I'm gonna drive. Open door, get into car. Drive. Yeah. Get into car. Close door. Fasten seat belt. Drive. All of that just to get going. Right, okay, so we dealt with red sports car lady Helen Hotz. She wasn't totally happy to see us, and that's not real surprising. I'm gonna try, though I don't think it's gonna. Enraged, the young woman shrieks as you drive off. "Your mama wears army boots, you Ed." Okay, so we're just gonna casually sort of proceed along. I don't think I'm gonna be able to get to the third thing I want to show you, which is sort of too bad because we're kind of running out of time, but that's okay. I'm gonna get us as close as I can, and then we'll save and have a look at that next week, possibly, depending on how kind of far we get. So where do we need to be? Not here. Okay, that's fine. I'm gonna get us sort of close-ish, and then I'm gonna call it an episode, unless of course I die, like I'm sort of going to do soon if I'm not careful. Right. Yeah. We'll be okay. I'm gonna just kind of casually go around the corner. The next thing that happens is in a place that we've seen before, so I'm just gonna get as close to there as I can and then kind of sit in the middle of the road. Like, for example, over here and save. Right. And that's about it for me. I'm Lost Wolf. Thank you so much for watching. This has been Police Quest 1, me dying and all. I hope you enjoyed the episode. I hope you have a great Easter. And I shall see you soon. Bye-bye, folks.